Steve, it seems that there is a lot of history in the Bible. Is that how you see it?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, the first thing is that it's an accurate historical account.
Mm-hmm.
The presentation is such, and the perspective of the writers, that they believed they were talking about real events.
Okay.
It's very obvious that because of the way in which they insist that the next generation learn mm-hmm. their history.
When you look at these early chapters in Genesis, what do you see? Can you take us through this?
It starts with, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. There's no word in Hebrew for universe. That means he created everything.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next thing we find in Genesis 1-2, we find a water ball that is in space.
Mm-hmm.
God, in the subsequent days, is going to fill that universe.
Well, you're talking about days here. Do you see these as literal days? Is that what the text is telling us? Or you know what other people think, that this is just a poetic, different
Well, first of all, it's not poetry. The world's greatest Hebraists all affirm that this is a narrative.
Mm-hmm.
They say that that's one of the unique features of the Genesis accounts of creation and the flood, is that they are narratives, because in the ancient Near East, they are done in epic poetry, which is very different. Now, here we have narrative to indicate that this is historical. What that means is that you should understand the words, the normal way in which those Hebrew words are understood. The word yom, it means day. The foundation of its usage is what we mean by a day. It's a 24-hour day. The only way you'd want it to mean a longer period of time is if you impose an alien concept to the text,
mm-hmm.
and say, well, I think that these are ages, and therefore yom has to mean ages. What you have to do is start with the text.
Yeah.
If we start with the text, yom means day.